Hi, I'm Dr. Vinod. It's been a long time, and today we will discuss about running diet. So, நிறைய பேர் கேட்குறாங்க இந்த புதுசாக ஒரு ரன்னிங் டயட் அப்படின்னு சொல்லி நிறைய அட்வர்டைஸ்மெண்ட்ஸ் பார்க்குறோம். இஸ் இட் ரியலி யூஸ்ஃபுல் அப்படின்னு. ஐ ஹேட் அ ஃபியூ க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் ரீசென்ட்லி, அரவுண்ட் அட்லீஸ்ட் 10 பீப்புள் மெசேஜ் ஆஸ்கிங் அபவுட் திஸ். ஸோ தி ஆன்சர் இஸ், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல், இஃப் யூ நாட் ட்ரைட் எனி டயட் இன் பர்டிகுலர் பிஃபோர், டோன்ட் ட்ரை எனி திங் நவ், பிகாஸ் ரன்னிங் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி ஸ்ட்ரென்யூஸ் ஆக்டிவிட்டி பை இட் செல்ஃப். And it will burn quite a number of calories compared to the other exercises that you do. So when you run, you have to be very careful about how you diet, because you will need quite a number of calories for running. So in case ungalku running la evlo calories burn aagudhu theriyala, you don't know how many calories you're burning while running, just download an app called Strava or Nike Running Club, and these apps will show you how many calories you burn after your activity. So there's a setting where you have to enter your weight, and if you do that, the app will show you how many calories you burn after you finish running or walking. The first thing that you should remember in your running diet is cut off all sources of junk food. So சிலர் என்ன நினைச்சுக்கிறாங்கன்னா, நம்ம ரன் பண்ணுறோம் அதனால என்ன வேணாலும் சாப்பிடலாம் அப்படின்னு நினச்சிக்கிறாங்க. The same goes for any other sport, whether be it cycling or swimming. I've seen many of these athletes, they have a lot of junk food. So that's very wrong. உங்களுக்கு weight loss இந்த இடத்துல, or in your tummy, if you want weight loss in your tummy, you should definitely avoid all junk foods. Having junk food like once in a week is not going to hurt you, but having junk food almost every day will have its toll, even if you're a very good runner. So be very careful to avoid junk foods. That is the main point that you have to remember in your running diet. Other than these, if you're aiming for a six-pack, or if you want good muscular body and you want a toned midsection, which you're not getting even with running or cycling, then I suggest that you follow the first technique that I'm about to tell you, that is intermittent fasting. So many beginners make the mistake of doing fasting daily, which is absolutely unnecessary, especially if you're young or lesser than 40 years of age. Don't fast daily. It's not required, because even 2 days of fasting per week will give you a weight loss of more than 1 kg, or fat loss of more than 1 kg per week. So be very careful with how you fast. If you keep doing this, your body will stop responding to fasting over a period of time. So don't fast too much, especially if you're young. You can increase the number of fasting days as you grow older. So once you cross 40, you can increase the number of fasting days to 3. And once you cross 50, you can increase the number of fasting days to 4. So there are many studies that say that fasting is very good for you. It has even been shown to improve the prognosis of cancer. And there are many other studies which say that fasting is helpful in weight loss. But the thevalama use panadinga. Start with 2 days of fasting per week, which is more than enough, because you're going to run. Okay? So that is one method. You cut off one meal per day. So it can either be lunch or breakfast or dinner. I usually go with dinner. And some people prefer cutting off breakfast or lunch. So do this twice a week. And the next main thing to remember about running diet is cutting off or reducing all sources of high glycemic carbohydrates. So this could be something like rice or roti or any other source of carbohydrate that will immediately increase the blood glucose levels in your body. So சாப்பிட்ட உடனே வந்து sugar level ஏறுற மாதிரி இருக்கிற கார்போஹைட்ரேட்டை தயவு செய்து தவிர்க்கவும். So try to reduce that. If you're having one bowl of rice, அதை half bowl ஆகும், make it half. So instead of that half bowl of rice, you can have something like an egg or a piece of meat or anything that can replace that half bowl of rice. This is just an example. So when you reduce your carbohydrates, you're teaching your body to use fats instead of carbohydrates. I usually don't recommend this method for elite or competition level runners, because they need a lot of carbohydrates when they are competing. If you are a recreational runner like me, or if you want six packs, then you can try this method. But இதுவுமே வந்து எடுத்த உடனே you should not do. You should not start off with this method. Start off with carbohydrates in your diet, and if this doesn't work, reduce the amount of carbohydrate so that your body will learn to use the energy from your body fat stores. So once your body learns to use fat as a main source of energy, konjam konjama you can start reducing carbohydrates until your body is comfortable using fat as a fuel. So this usually takes around 1 or 2 years for it to happen. So you have to be consistent with your running. So let me recap. The first method is cutting off all junk foods. The second method, if you're interested, you can go and for intermittent fasting twice a week and then slowly increase the number of days every 10 years. And then the third method is reducing carbohydrates so that your body will learn to use fat as a fuel for running. So all these methods are not really necessary as long as you cut off junk foods first. So if that doesn't work, then go in for the other two. Don't unnecessarily follow diets just because they're giving results, because your body is going to burn enormous number of calories while running. So be very careful with how you diet, give your body adequate nutrition, and slowly reduce unnecessary carbohydrates, and this will get you to a good diet for your running schedule. For more interesting stuff like this, please don't hesitate to subscribe and hit the bell button. Thank you.